I know you are here ready for the word of God.
但是我相信你们大家都预备好听神的话语。
It's an amazing day. So many things happening.
好棒好棒日子，很多东西在发生。
But the most important thing is what God is doing in your hearts.
但是最重要的是上帝在你心做的工。
How many of you enjoyed Fred, Mimi, and James? They're
当然享受听 Fred, Mimi, and James.
Why don't we give them a big hand?
好吧，为他们热烈的拍掌。
Pastor Shirley and I were actually at Welfare Wheel where they are based at the ministry.We visited them last year.
我们去年去探过他们。
So we've seen their work.
我们看过他们的工作。
And you know, we can vouch for them.
我们也可以为他们支持他们。
We highly recommend their ministry.
我们很强力推荐他们的事工。
And the important thing that we wanted you to see is that they are the fruits of that ministry.
而最重要看你们看见的就是他们就是他们事工的结果。
So this is the virtuous cycle that we want to see.
这是一直在循环的这个环节。
Someone is lifted up from poverty.
有人从贫穷里面被提升。
And they become the people that lift others out from poverty.
他们变成提升另外一个人从贫穷出来的人。
So they are the first generation.
他们是第一代。
And then there's James.
然后还有 James.
And then there's about 20 other children listed outside in a booth.
然后大概还有20个儿童在外面。
They want to encourage you to go and sponsor.
在外面柜台那边要鼓励大家能够去赞助他们。
To lift those children up from poverty.
也让这些儿童能被提升从脱离贫穷。
So that they also can lift others out of poverty.
让他们也能够提升别人离开贫穷好吗？
So let's give Bukang Lee YY and this wonderful team a big, big hand.
我们掌声给黎明会社跟这些团队。
Amen.So it's Missions Weekend.
今天是宣教周末。
And it's always exciting during this time.
常常都感觉很棒的。
Because it's a time when we are not just looking inward in our lives.
因为这个时候我们不是往里面看。
But as a church, we want to look outside the four walls.
但是身为教会我们要往四墙以外展望。
So I want to share some stories with you this morning.
今天早上跟大家分享一些故事。
And I believe you'll be challenged and inspired.
相信能够挑战大家，能够激励大家。
Because the theme of this mission weekend is send me.
因为今年的宣教主题是差遣我。
So turn to your neighbor and say send me.
找向旁边人说差遣我。
And in accordance with that theme,
而在按照这个主题
I have a message today I entitled The Adventurous Life.
我的信息主题叫做冒险人生。
So tell your neighbor you're going to enjoy this journey.
告诉旁边人你会享受这个旅程。
Let us pray.
让我们祷告。
Father God,
父啊,
we want to thank you for your presence here today.
我们感谢同在与我们在一起。
And we thank you that you are a sending God.
我们感谢你是差遣我们的上帝。
When you sent Jesus to us 2,000 years ago.
两千年前你差耶稣到我们世界来。
And so as followers of Jesus,
身为耶稣的跟从者,
we also want to be sent out.
我们也要被差遣。
So we pray for your word to speak to our hearts.
祷告你的话语能够向我们心说话。
Not just to inform our minds,
不只是给我们资讯,
but to transform us from inside.
而且从内到外转变我们。
So we open our hearts to you.
今天我们向你敞开我们心。
Speak to us.
请你向我们说话。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Everybody say.
每个人说。
Amen.
Amen.
In 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 to 27.
更多后书十一章二三到二七节。
Paul talks about his missionary life.
保罗讲到他的宣教生涯。
All the different things that he's gone through.
他所经过的起起伏伏每一个东西。
So I'll read the whole passage in English first.
先用英文来读。
And then after that, Andrew will read.
再用中文来读。好。
Paul says here, I've worked harder, been put in prison, more often been whipped times without number, and faced death again and again. 5 different times the Jewish leaders gave me 39 lashes. 3 times I was beaten with rods. Once I was stoned. 3 times I was shipwrecked. Once I spent a whole night and a day adrift at sea. I've traveled on many long journeys.I face dangers from rivers and from robbers. I face dangers from my own people, the Jews, as well as from the Gentiles. I face dangers in the cities, in the deserts, and on the seas. And I face danger from men who claim to be believers but are not. I work hard and long, enduring many sleepless nights. I've been hungry and thirsty and have often gone without food.I've shivered in the cold without enough clothing to keep me warm.
我比他们多受劳苦，多下监牢，受鞭打是过重的，冒死是屡次有的。被犹太人鞭打五次，每次40减去一下；被棍打了三次，被石头打了一次；遇着船坏三次，一昼一夜在深海里；又屡次行远路，遭江河的危险、盗贼的危险、同族的危险、外邦人的危险、城里的危险、旷野的危险、海中的危险、假弟兄的危险，受劳碌、受困苦，多次不得。又饥又渴，多次不得食，受寒冷，赤身露体。
Now, how many of you want to live a life like this?
请问多少人喜欢这种人生？
Yes, some of you, right?
可能有些人举手。
Well, maybe not the whipping part or the lashes and the beatings.
可能先不要讲鞭打、棍打、殴打。
But that description, certainly Paul lived an adventurous life.
但是这种描述能够让你看到保罗的人生是冒险的人生。
And today we celebrate Paul's life.
而今天我们欢庆保罗的生平。
Why?
为什么？
Because he gave everything to live a life filled with meaning.
因为他奉献了一切，活出有意义的人生。
Now, how many of you have heard of the Mars One project? Anyone?
当然听过火星一号计划。
Okay, some of you.
有些人听过哈。
For those of you who do not know, let me tell you what it is.
还没听过的，跟人哥告诉你是什么东西。
Mars One is a not-for-profit foundation with the goal of establishing a permanent human settlement on Mars.
火星一号是一家非盈利公司，目的是在火星建立能够让人类居住永久殖民地。
So to prepare for this settlement,
为了要准备这个殖民地。
The first unmanned mission is scheduled to depart in 2020.
第一项无人操管任务预计在2020年出发。
So what they will do is they will send crews 4 at a time after that.
他们会拆检这个宇航员四个人一次。
The first crew of 4 will leave on 2026.
这个每一次四个人会从2026年离开。
After that, every 26 months, they will send another 4.
接下来26个月呢，四个人一组的人员会接续去火星。
Well, here's the catch.
唯一的条件是,
it's a one-way journey.
这是单程之旅哦。
I mean, anyone can apply for this when it was open at the time.
在公开的时候，任何人可以去申请。
How many of you, if you knew about this, then you would have applied?
当然觉得如果你知道的话，会想去申请。
Yeah, some hands, okay?
有些会举手,
few of you.
可能有些人。
Mars One claims that 200,000 people expressed interest.
据火星一号，有20万人已经表示兴趣。
With more than 4,000 actually submitting applications.
超过4,000人实际送出注册。
Where they pick a final crew of 100.
真正的缴费呢, 只有100人左右。
4,000 people applied.
4,000人哦, 申请哦。
Why would anyone sign up for a one-way ticket to Mars, never coming back?
人们为什么要报名去参加这个单程之旅, 去到火星不再回来了?
Because everybody wants to give something that's bigger than their lives.
因为每个人都希望能够奉献比他们自己生命更大的东西。
They want to live for something that's meaningful.
他们希望能够活，为一些有意义的东西而活。
I may never come back.
不再回来哦。
But have you gone to Mars?
但是你有到过火星吗？
I have.
我有去过耶。
Something so much bigger than their lives.
比他们人生更大的东西。
Mark Twain said this.
马克吐温曾经说过。
The two most important days in your life are the day you are born and the day you find out why.
人一生有两个最重要的日子，一是出生的那天，二是发现你为何而生的那一天。Well,
today I'm not asking you to go to Mars.
今天不是要送你们去火星了。But
how about going to Myanmar?
但是如果去缅甸怎么办？
You know, we Christians, we are called to live an adventurous life.
我们基督徒蒙召活出冒险刺激的人生。
And the term we use is called missions.
而我们用的字眼叫宣教。So
everyone shout out missions.
Missions.
Yeah, that's the adventurous life.
这就是冒险的人生。
Now, Pastor Shirley and I, we've been on many, many mission trips.
我跟上, Pastor Shirley 曾经去过很多的短宣。
And we've been going for missions since we were very young.
从小就已经开始去宣教了。
And our involvement in missions has shaped us to be the people that we are today.
因为我们参与宣教，今天我们成为我们成今天的人。
Pastor Shirley started to go on mission trips when she was 17 years old.
所以传道从17岁开始已经参加短宣。
She volunteered to serve at a mission organization known as STAMP.
她自愿去服侍一个名叫 STAMP的宣教机构。
Which is Strategic Mission Program.
就是策略宣教计划。
So she would go to the STEM office.
她会去到 STEM的办公室。
She volunteered to help out, and that's where she learned a lot about cross-cultural missions and the different mission fields.
自愿帮忙在那里学习了很多关于跨文化宣教跟各地的宣教合场。
So she started to develop a heart for certain nations.
她开始对一些国家特别有负担。
As she studied about the different ethnic groups and all their different
cultures. 学习各个族群跟文化。
So she was one of the assistants to the founder director of the organization.
那么身为该机构的创办人兼执行长的助理之一。
And that's where she learned how to organize mission trips.
就是在那里学习如何组织短宣。
So understand she went for a mission trip to Laos.
在 STEM 的时候，他参加个这个短宣到了寮国。
Or Muang Lao,
或者也叫做老挝。
And also a few mission trips to Rao, ministering to the Orang Asli.
还有几个到老挝去服侍原住民的短宣。
She was the youngest member in all those trips.
在短宣团队里面，她是最年轻的团友。
So in Laos, the people were actually quite resistant towards foreigners coming into their land.
寮国人民对老外来到他们的土地，他们不太喜欢。
They thought that the foreigners were coming to take something away from their land.
他们觉得老外来是要从他们中间夺走东西。
However, when she preached, led worship, and shared a testimony, and spent most of her time fellowshipping and connecting with the locals,
但是当她讲到带敬拜、分享她的见证，花很多时间跟那边当地的老百姓交团契交流的时候，
these people felt loved.
这些人感到爱了。
And when they saw the love of God through the team,
他们看到神的爱借着团队而来，
their hearts became open.
他们的心就敞开了。
And they were deeply touched by God.
他们深深被神感动。
Come on, let's give God a big hand.
好吧，为神热烈的拍掌。
Amen.
Amen.
So Shirley started young, immersing herself in cross-cultural missions.
Shirley 很年轻就已经开始参与这个跨文化宣教。
And as a result of what she did when she was young, today she's able to connect and serve communities anywhere in the world.
因为这样，今天她很容易可以去到各地去服侍任何的族群。
Missions has shaped her life deeply.
宣教大大影响了她的生命。
Now for me, recently I've also been reflecting.
我最近也一直在想哦。
And I was thinking,Why is it today I'm so bold to pray for people for healing?
今天我为什么那么勇敢，可以敢去为别人祷告医治？
Honestly, I don't feel much fear when I pray for miracles for people.
老实说，为别人求神迹的时候，我不觉得太害怕。
So as I was thinking about it, there are many reasons I came up with.
当我在想的时候，我就发现好多个理由。
But I realized that one of the main factors that influenced me.
但是我发现最主要的理由是
was a mission trip that I went to when I was very young.
就是我很小的时候参加过的宣教。
I was part of a life-changing mission trip to Sarawak after I completed my chambering before I started working as a lawyer.
我刚刚结束实习，还没有正式当律师之前，我参加了一个翻转我生命的撒拉越短宣。
This trip was very significant for me.
这个短宣对我来说非常有意思。
Because it was the first time in my Christian life that I experienced amazing miracles.
因为是我信主后第一次，我见证到好多奇妙的神迹。
I remember there was one meeting that we were at.
我记得其中有一个聚会，
and there was a whole line of people on the stage.
有很多人在台前为要被接受祷告。
And so my back was, you know, like to the audience.
我的背后在面向会众。
And I was just praying for people.
我在为别人祷告。
Then as I prayed, and then I kind of looked back, I saw someone being brought in on a stretcher by people.
在祷告，我转身一看的时候，有人被抬着进来。
So the guy was lying on a stretcher and being brought and put on the stage.
那个人躺在床上，然后被抬到台上来。
So as I was praying, I saw at the corner of my eye that the pastor was praying for the guy on the stretcher.
在祷告的时候，我从眼角边能够看到牧师在为那个人祷告。
And not very long after that, I turned and I saw the guy was already up on his feet.
不久以后，当我转身，我看到那个人站起来了。
And then suddenly, I heard the whole church clapping.
哇！突然间，整个教会轰动起来，大家都在拍掌。
I turned around and I saw the guy was running up and down the stage.
哇！看到那个人在台上走上走下嘞。
He was immediately healed that day.
他是当场得到医治。
Come on, let's give God a big hand.
为神热烈的拍掌。
He came in on a stretcher. He ran home after that.
他走进来是被抬着进来，可是回家是走出去的。
Come on, let's give God one more big hand.
为神再次热烈的拍掌。
That was when I experienced what the book of Acts said.
我就是体验到《使徒行传》所说的
about the lame man who was walking and jumping and praising God.
那瘸腿的人走着跳着赞美神。
I saw in my very own eyes.
我亲眼看到了。
Now this other man we visited in his home.
又有另外一个先生，我们去探访他。
And you know his home was very dark.
他的家里很黑暗。
And he was in his bed.
他躺在床上。
High fever,
整个人发高烧
no energy to even stand up on his feet,
根本没有气力站起来
sick for months,
已经病了好几个月了
and we just prayed and prayed for him,
我们一直在为他祷告
but nothing happened,
但是没有东西发生
during the night,
当天晚上
God touched him,
上帝触摸了他
and healed him,
医治了他
and in the morning before we were leaving that place,
早上我们要离开那个乡村的时候
we saw him fully dressed,
看见他穿着衣服整个人很有生气
walking down the path towards us,
走着路来迎向我们
and I just cried when I saw this man transformed by the power of God,
那一刻看到神怎么翻转那个人我哭了
Hallelujah, come on, let's give God a hand. This lady,
这个女人
she had a machine fall on her hip,
有机器压到他的臀部。
Okay, the lady that is praying there. So as a result of that, it dislocated and affected her hip.
因为被压伤，所以她的腰部已经脱臼了。
And so the left foot became 2 inches shorter than the right. So it's almost like that.
左腿比右腿呢短了两寸。
So she's been walking with a limp ever since that accident happened to her.
从那个意外开始哦，她一直一瘸一拐的走。
But as we prayed for her,
但是当我们为他们祷告的时候,
we saw her leg.
我们看见她的腿,
literally grow out.
实际的伸展了,
and come to almost the same length as the other leg.
然后变成跟另外一只腿同样长度,
right before our very eyes.
就在我们的眼前。
Come on, let's give God a big hand.
好吧，再次为神热烈的拍掌, Hallelujah.
Not only did I experience or see miracles,
我不光是见证亲眼看到了神迹,
but I myself saw many people healed as I laid hands on them myself.
我自己在为别人按手祷告的时候，看到好多人得到医治。
For me, the most significant healing that I experienced through my own prayer and hands,
对我来说，我自己经历过最大最伟大的神迹就是,
was a man who was deaf in one ear.
有一个人他耳聋一边。
So when you snap your fingers on one side, he could hear.
你在旁边打手的时候，他根本听不见。
And you snap on the other side, and there's no response from him.
一边听得见，一边听不见。
But after praying for him a few times,
但是跟他祷告了好几遍以后,
his ears completely opened and he could hear.
他两边耳朵打开了，完全能够听到。
He was healed of his deafness. Come on, give Jesus a big hand.
就在那天得到医治，为神热烈的拍掌。
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! 每个人说。
Amen.
Amen.
So why do I have boldness and faith to pray for people today?
今天我干嘛有这种勇气能够为别人祷告?
Because the miracle working power of God is not a theory for me.
因为神行神迹的能力对我来说不是一个理论。
It is a reality that I have experienced.
是我亲身经历过的真实。
So in the past 20 years since my first mission trip,
在过去20年从我第一次宣教到现在,
I've been on more than 20 mission trips.
我参加过了超过20场的宣教.
So that's almost like an average of one trip a year.
大概是平均每一年一次以上.
Every single trip has shaped me and molded me to be the person I am today.
每一次的短宣都改变了我生命，让我今天成为我今天的我。
Now, Shirley and I, we have a godson, a 16-year-old godson who lives in Melbourne.
Shirley跟我呢，在墨尔本有一位16岁的义子。
His name is Daniel Koo.
他名叫邱恩胜。
Now, like every teenager,
跟其他少年人一样,
he's going through the usual challenging transition from childhood to adulthood.
他在面对从儿童时期进到成年时期的一种过渡。
Not only that, his parents are pastors of a church in Melbourne.
不光是这样，他父母在墨尔本是牧师。
So his faith is just like another part of his life.
所以信仰对他来说只是生活的一部分而已。
So we decided that Daniel needed a life-changing encounter on the mission field.
我们决定了要恩胜能够亲自体验在宣教合场上面生命怎么得到改变。
So at the end of last year,
所以去年底,
we included Daniel into our mission trip to Chiang Mai.
我们请Daniel跟我们一起到清迈短宣。
So I want to read out to you Daniel's testimony after that trip.
我要给大家知道他们从转宣回来的时候他的见证是怎么样的。
This is what he shared with us.
他跟我们分享这样子。
I've never been on a mission trip before, so this trip was a first for me.
我从来没有参加过短宣，这是我人生第一次。
Although the trip was supposed to bring love and help to the Korean people that we ministered to,
短宣原来是要把爱和帮助带给我们服侍的克伦族。
I also learned many different things throughout the expedition.
但是我也从不同方面学到了很多。
The children really showed their big hearts to me by helping generously whenever they felt they could.
克伦小孩随时乐意地帮助我的时候，我真的感到他们的大方胸怀。
Their care for each other is absolute because of their undying love for one another.
他们对彼此的关怀是无私的，因为他们对彼此的爱心是绵绵不绝的。
Most importantly, the Korean children love for Jesus is very pure.
最重要的是，克伦族小朋友对耶稣的爱是那么的纯真。
During worship, they sing from the bottom of their hearts as best and as loud as they can.
敬拜的时候，他们尽力大声地从心里唱歌。
Listen to this part.
听到这部分哦。
The worship I've experienced in my life, from high-tech Christian conferences to small churches, cannot be compared to the way the children express their love to Jesus.
我人生所经历过的敬拜，从高科技的基督徒特会到小教会的敬拜，都不能跟那些小孩子对耶稣表达的爱做比较。
The worship team only consists of a singer and a guitarist and an untuned old guitar.
敬拜团只有一位主领和一位吉他手，而且是还没有调好音的旧吉他。
Without a projector for lyrics, a keyboardist, or a sound system.
那里没有幻灯片放歌词，没有键盘手或音响系统。
Even so, their lack of technology does not hinder the way the kids shout their praise for the Lord.
虽然如此，科技的缺乏却拦阻不了小朋友向主大声的赞美。
Although the mission trip is supposed to bless the Korean people in as many ways as possible,
虽然短宣一开始应该是尽量去祝福客伦族，
I cannot come away from the trip not being blessed myself.
但是我却从短宣带着满满的祝福回来。
I've experienced a pure joy and love in community.
我在社群中经历到了纯真的喜乐和爱。
Where I live, there is no community concern where everyone is caring first for everyone around them.
我居住的地方从没有社群把关怀别人摆在优先，大家只顾自己。
In Melbourne, it is every man for himself.
在墨尔本，大家只顾自己的需要。
Money is first.
拜金主义第一。
Your own self is first.
自我主义第一。
There is no love like what I've experienced in Chiang Mai.
从来没有跟我在清迈所经历的爱那样。
I cannot help but repeat.
我必须要再说一遍。
The children care for each other like I've never seen before.
小孩子对彼此的关怀是我前所未见的。
Listen to this.
听好这个。
Even though the children have extremely little possessions and money, they are not poor.
即使他们有极少的财产跟金钱，他们一点也不穷。
They have next to nothing.
他们拥有寥寥无几。
They only have a few sets of clothing.
只有几套衣服穿。
A leaf roof over their head.
一夜屋檐庇护。
And just enough food to scrape through.
只有足够的粮食挨过去。
But they do not act or think they are poor.
但是他们从来不假装自己或觉得自己穷。
Even I, who knows how much they are lacking.
就连我虽然知道他们真的很缺很多
Do not feel like I'm in a poor environment
在那里一点也不感觉到在穷人家里
I actually feel their wealth and riches in one another
事实上我感觉到他们在彼此里面找到的财富跟富足
Many people nowadays, millionaires and billionaires People with large bank accounts and many properties are still poor
今年很多人是百万或千万富翁好多人有丰裕的银行户口和房地产却仍然很穷
Many of these wealthy people are unhappy and always wanting more.
这些有钱人都感觉不快乐，一直想要更多。
Because they cannot find their true purpose or happiness.
因为他们找不到真正的目的或幸福。
The Korean people have nothing, but they are happier and more joyous than I've ever witnessed.
反观克伦人囊空如洗，却比我见过的人更幸福更开心。
They take whatever little possessions they have and create fun out of it.
他们从自己匮乏之中制造出喜乐。
A rope.A clothesline, a tree, and they can be happy for hours.
一条绳子，一条晾衣线，一棵树，就可以让他们开心玩好几个小时。
Kids today have everything they can possibly want.
今天很多小孩什么都有。
Computers, iPads, smartphones, mountains of toys, but they are still wanting more and more.
电脑、iPad、智能手机、玩具堆积如山，但是他们想要还要更多。
I've learned from this trip that true happiness is not gained from possessions.
我从这次的短宣里学到，真正的幸福不是从物质得到的，
but from community and love for one another.
而是当社群中有彼此相爱。
I would love to go again to another mission trip because I've experienced so much in just one trip.
我希望能参加下一次的短宣，因为光是这一次我已经体验良多。
Next time, I would love to help out.With their lives, even more than this trip, with whatever I can contribute.
下一次，我希望能够在我能贡献的任何方面帮助他们，比这次更多。
Since that trip last year,
从去年的短宣开始到现在
，Daniel has never been the same again.
恩生已经不再一样了。
This mission trip has shaped his life permanently.
这一次的短宣大大永久改变了他的生命。
Let's give God a big, big hand. Hallelujah!
为神热烈的拍掌 ，Hallelujah!
In fact, just yesterday.
事实上，昨天
is when they have their church service on Saturdays.
他们礼拜六有教会聚会。
He preached for the very first time in the church service.
他第一次在教会讲道。
Come on, let's give God a big hand.
再次为神热烈的拍掌。
Parents, listen to me.
家长们，你们听好。
If you want to make a difference in the lives of your children,
如果你也希望你的孩子生命也得到改变
send them for missions.
不妨送他们去短宣
invest in their lives.
投资在他们生命中
and all the parents say,
所有家长说
Amen. Amen. So this year, we want to do something different.
今年我们要稍作调整
This is like a youth weekend with the launch of Euphoria.
这个周末有 Euphoria 被介绍，这个是青少年的周末
So we want to invest in our young people.
我们希望能够投资在我们年轻人身上
So this year, we are going to tithe our mission fund to strictly students.
所以今年我们会把宣教基金的十分之一拨给仅限学生。
10% of the mission fund is going to go to SS so that their young people can go for missions.
宣教基金的百分之十会分配给 SS, 鼓励我们的年轻人参加宣教。兴奋吗？
So if we can raise at least 200,000 in pledges today,
所以如果今天在我们任线中能够筹到至少20万令吉,
that will mean next year SS will have at least 20,000 for mission trips.
代表明年 SS 至少有20,000令吉来拆派我们学生去短宣.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. So the mission fund. It's not just for us to bless the nations.
宣教基金不是让我们能够祝福万国而已。
It's also for us to invest in the vitality of the life of our people.
也让我们能够投资在我们会众的生活精神上。
We're not just giving for others.
不只是要奉献给别人。
We're also investing in ourselves.
也要为自己的世代付出。
For when we go for missions, our lives will never be the same again.
因为一旦有人到宣教回来，他们的生命永远不再一样。
Everybody say.
每个人说。
Amen.
Amen.
So. What is the fruit of all the years of mission involvement that Shirley and I have been a part of?
所以过去几年我跟Shirley服侍过的短宣有什么成果呢?
Well, after all these years,
这几年以来,
we are both taking a crazy step of faith.
我们两个要疯狂跨出信心的一步,
we are selling everything.
我们变卖了一切,
and we are stepping out into the mission field.
我们要跨入宣教合唱。
It's a bit emotional for me.
对我来说有一点情绪化。
See, back in September last year,
去年9月,
Pastor Keith, he preached a very powerful sermon.
Keith 传道讲了一篇很大能的道,
called Venturing Out.
叫做这次走出去了。
Do you remember that message?
记得那篇讲道吗?
Yeah, some of you do. Okay.
有些人记得。
And at the end of the sermon,
在讲到最后,
Keith was challenging us.
Keith 在挑战我们。
And I heard God say to me, go.
我感受神在跟我说, 去吧。
And then I asked God, go where?
我说去哪里?
Because it wasn't as though I had any plans to go anywhere. So it wasn't like a confirmation of something I had already been thinking about. So after the service, Shirley and I, we went out for dinner. And I said, I only heard this one word, go, nothing else. And as we discussed, we kind of said, yeah, we kind of feel maybe there's a transition in our life coming up. But what does it mean? So we started to talk about different countries have we been to?
所以开始讨论我们去过的各个国家。
Is God calling us to Myanmar?
是去缅甸吗?
No, we didn't feel like
不是,
it was Myanmar.
没有感觉到这样子。
Then Shirley said she got a heart for China and Taiwan.
所以说我对中国跟台湾有负担。
But my husband Banana cannot speak Chinese.
但是我丈夫是香蕉人，不会说中文怎么办？
So, no, probably not a good idea.
所以应该不是好主意了。
So we went through a whole list and there was no conclusion.
讨论了好几个国家，但是没有结论。
So Shirley said, maybe God is not talking about a country.
所以说，可能神不是在说一个国家吧。
Maybe God is asking you to go into politics.
可能上帝要你介入政坛。
And I said, I have thought about it before.
是啦，我有想过，我说。
But honestly, I don't have a strong conviction for it.
但是老实说，我心里没有很大的感动。
So, no conclusion.
所以也是没有定局。
So I went home and I wrote an email to Pastor Kevin.
所以我回到家，我寄了一封信给 Pastor Kevin.
I said, Pastor, I heard this word, go.
我说，牧师，我听到这句话，去吧。
I don't know what it means.
我不知道什么意思。
But if you do, please share with us and you know guide us.
但是如果你有感动的话，请你跟我们分享来指引我们。
Well, 2 weeks after that, we had a family trip to Melbourne.
2个礼拜过后呢，我们家人一起到墨尔本去那边度假。
And while I was in Melbourne,
我们在墨尔本的时候。
God actually reminded me that 15 years ago I had this vision to one day reach out to the university students.
神提醒了我大概15年前让我看到这个意向能够去接触大学生。
And as we talk about it, Shirley also shared that she has a vision for students.
我们在分享当中, Shirley 也跟我分享说她有一个对学生有负担。
And it's also a particular people group that are now found in large members in Australia.
也有一个特别在那里很多的族群有负担。
So during this trip, two doors opened for us.
在这度假当中两扇门打开了。
The first was the opportunity to expand my business into Australia.
首先就是我有机会把我的生意发展到澳洲。
And the second was for Shirley to upgrade her studies.
第二是让Shirley可以在那边继续深造。
To continue her studies.
继续在那边念书。
You see, more than 15 years ago,
超过15年前,
Shirley was studying in Melbourne.
Shirley在墨尔本那边念大学。
She had only one more semester to go before she got her bachelor degree.
剩下最后一个学期就可以念完学士了。
But she received news that Pastor Kevin was going to start a new church here.
但是她听到消息说劳牧师要在这里开办新的教会。
And it resonated with her heart to go into full-time ministry and serve God.
她心里面马上有感动, 想要进入全职服侍神。
So she felt called to give up her studies and come back here to Malaysia.
她觉得有呼召, 放下她的学业, 回到马来西亚。
And support Pastor Kevin in pioneering this church.
支援牧师一起创办教会。
And she became the first full-time staff in City Harvest Church.
她在城市丰收教会成为了教会第一位同工。
So it was a very big step of faith for her.
对她来说是信心的好大一步。
And so now, God was opening the door for her to return to Melbourne to pursue her education.
现在上次再次，上帝再次把门打开，让她回到墨尔本去继续她的学业。
I will tell you, It's not an easy decision for us.
我告诉你，对我们来说，这个决定一点也不容易。
City Harvest Church, you are our family.
城市丰收教会，你们是我们的家庭。
I've been here for more than 10 years.
我在这里已经超过十年了。
And Shirley's been here from the very beginning.
Shirley 从一开始到现在都在。
This is our home.
这是我们的家。
And we treasure every single relationship here.
我们非常珍惜所有的感情跟关系。
So a lot of confirmation came in the following weeks.
所以在接下来几个礼拜就很多印证来了。
And we finally met up with Pastor Kevin.
最后我们跟老牧师碰面。
And when we shared what God has spoken to us to him,
当我们跟他分享神放在我们心里面负担的时候，
it resonated with his heart.
他心里也有同感。
Because both Pastor Kevin and the church was being shifted into a new season by God at that time.
因为老牧师跟教会在整个都在被神移向新的季节里面。
And it was then that we realized that it's not something that God is just doing in Shirley and my life.
我们就开始发现，原来不是神在跟我跟 Shirley 的生命中动工而已。
But God is doing something much bigger.
神在做的事是比我们想象中更大的。
And we're just one piece of the bigger picture.
我们只是拼图中的一小块。
So in 2 weeks' time,
所以再过两周，
we are leaving our beloved Malaysia to venture out.
我们要离开我们心爱的马来西亚，勇敢跨出去。
And Keith, it's all your fault.
都是你酿的祸。
In a good way.
好的啦，好方面哈。
You know, honestly, a lot of people ask us tons of questions.
老实说，很多人问我们好多好多的问题。
We do not know what shape or what form, what it will look like at this moment.
我们对前景是怎么样，长得什么样貌，完全一无所知。
We're just going to take the first step of faith and let God lead us on the journey.
我们只想跨出信心的一步，其他的让神来带领。
We can't tell you what the future holds.
根本不能告诉你未来是怎么样。
Who knows? Maybe even in a year's time, we are back.
谁知道？可能一年以后我们又回来了。
I don't know.
我不知道。
There's something Pastor Keith said at the end of his sermon.
但是在 Keith 讲的最他的讲章最后那部分有一个东西
that was so powerful.
是非常有能力。
And that's why we hold on very close to our hearts.
因此我们一直紧抱怀里。
Keith said this.
Keith 这么说哦。
What if you venture out and you never accomplish what you ventured out for?
万一你走出去，但没有完成你想要走出去完成的事，怎么办？
But in venturing out, you gain God.
然而，当你跨出去的时候，你得着的是上帝。
You encountered and experienced Him.
你遇见了他，你经历了他。
Wouldn't that be worth it?
这样何尝不是值得一拼的吗？
That's what we have decided to do.
因此，这就是我们的决定。
At the end of the day, it's not our destination.
到最后，重点不是终点。
It's the journey.
而是路程。
And most importantly for Shirley and I, we want to gain God.
而最重要的，对我跟 Shirley 来说，我们要得着的是上帝。
So today we're not just talking.
今天我们不是纸上谈兵。
We are walking the talk.
我们是身体力行。
We are taking a step of faith.
我们要跨出信心的一步。
Over the years, we've been faithfully praying and giving.
过去几年，我们一直在奉献祷告。
Now, we are going.
现在我们要出去了。
What about you?
今天你呢?
Some of you, God is calling you to go.
有的人上帝在呼召你出去。
But for the rest of us, will we pray and give today?
但是其他的人今天你愿不愿意祷告跟奉献?
Will you both be a blessing to the nations?
你愿不愿意成为万国的祝福而已?
As well as invest in the lives of our young people.
同时也要投资在我们年轻人的生命里。
So let's get ready to pledge.
好吧,今天我们预备好来认献。